Love it. Welcome. Welcome. Nice to see you all. You guys are about as... This whole crowd's about as handsome as those two are backstage. I'm not surprised that there's quite a few ladies in the room. You've got some handsome-looking devils out here. Both had a haircut. They both look very trim, taut and terrific. Quite exciting. Which brings me to the point, when you get your photos taken, no tongue kissing, no holding hands, none of that sort of stuff, all right? Just stand there and have your photo taken with them. Be polite, be cordial. But, I mean, if the urge grabs you, jeez, I was nearly doing it out there. What can I tell you? It's very exciting. Welcome along to That's Good for Footy. My name's Damien. It's wonderful to have you here. Welcome to Western Bulldogs Night. You are at the Mulgrave Country Club. We appreciate your patronage and we enjoy that you're going to be here. Thank you. And I like to say, as I do every week, welcome to That's Good for Footy. We're the only live and interactive footy panel show going around in Australia. This is where the fans meet the players and the players meet the fans. And you get to meet the players in a little bit of a different light. And that's what this show is all about. So without any further ado, let's get the two boys out of here so you can have a bit of a perv. All right, here we go. Our first panellist, he was born on the 9th of January 1997. He's played a total of 82 games and kicked a total of 44 goals. He made his AFL debut back in 2016 when he plays for the Western Bulldogs Football Club. He wears the number 5 on his back. Could you please welcome to the stage, Josh Dunkley? Another one coming, so we'll just save that song. Did I tell you he was looking quite debonair? You'd have to agree. He looks fantastic. How are you, mate? You well?
I'm good, mate. Yeah. Feeling really good and really excited about what we can do this year.
Yeah, good. I'm excited too. I've got reason to be excited because I've done quite a few shows with this boy, but he's in different colours tonight, and I'm very happy about that. And I'm sure you are too, because he's performing very well down at the Western Bulldogs. Down the kennel, isn't that right? Yeah. He's our second panellist. He was born on the 9th of March in 1993. He's played a total of 177 games and he's kicked 100 goals. He made his AFL debut back in 2012. And when he plays for the Western Bulldogs Football Club, he wears the number 1 on his back. Please welcome to the stage, Adam Treloar. All right, sing it. You want it? Bulldogs blue and Bulldogs fight and Bulldogs roar. We give our very best. Cause you can't beat the boys of the Bulldog Creed. We're the team of the mind. All right, well done. Thank you very much. Adam Treloar, how are you, mate? Nice to see you.
Nice to see you, mate. I'm going well.
How wonderful is it? I like seeing you in these colours. It suits you.
I always thought they suited me, but I never thought I'd be wearing one, but I'm very happy.
Oh, no, it's great. I'm so stoked to have both boys here. I know that they've got a bit of a bromance going on. I've had one going on with these boys as well, separate, but now we're all three here together. I feel a bit of a love fest going on, so it's nice to have you both here and nice of you to be present here tonight. I want to get stuck into it. It's going to be our first segment. It's called What's Going On? What's going on? You can look as puzzled as you want, because sometimes the guys up here are as well. They go, what's going on, Damo? But what I wanted to talk about, I want to do this on a little bit of a serious nature, and then we'll get in and have a bit of fun as the night goes on. But every week I listen to the media, and I listen to them bang on about the media over-analysing the game. And it's probably more paramount than what's been happening this week when you see, and I don't mean this to be referencing it towards Collingwood, but it started off with Nathan Buckley and how the media have come out and haven't had a win and what's going on down there. I don't want to go into that, but I just want to talk about that being the topic, because that's what the media tend to sensationalise. I think when you talk about it, you think from, and you guys have probably heard this all the way through from your junior footy to where you are now, there's many things that it takes in order to be a good footballer and what happens on the field. You've got game plan, structure, implementation, personnel, knowing your role, reliability and consistency, along with the mental side of it, pressure. Pressure is actual or perceived. You'd agree with that, wouldn't you? There is scoreboard pressure, there's tackling pressure, there's defensive pressure, game plan. The idea to make every contest you're involved in a winner. That'd be true. You want to rely on a team win and not just an individual win. You're all there as a collective. You train together, you play together. It's all in, it's one in, all in. Structure and personnel. Your forward line is really starting to gel, which is great. Your first few rounds, I could hear everyone going from the wah-wah ambulance. You know, we want Josh Bruce, everybody wants his head. Now he's come out, he, English and Norton, they've kicked 32 goals in the first four rounds. Yeah, please. The point I wanted to make with that is that that's more than your leading goal kicker kicked all of last year, and this is only round four. So it's exciting times down at the kennel. My point being, when you get things right, or you get the mix right, or the right mix, things will happen. You've lost key forwards over the last 5 years, whether they be through injury, retirement, trade, or for personal reasons. Players like Dixon, Cloak, Stringer, Boyd, Lloyd, Picken, and Cramery, and this is where structure and personnel come into play. So implementation. You win the contested ball and you win the clearances, both from the centre bounce and from stoppages around the ground. Get it in fast, not giving the opposition time to set up. So far, everything I'm saying is making sense. Yeah. Right.
Just nodding, mate. Nodding.
You sound like a coach, mate.
I can see you both nodding. Right. But you go, fast ball movement and running in numbers is the key to on-field success. This style of football is more prevalent in today's brand of football than maybe more than ever before. But primarily, it's always been there throughout history. This formula has always been there. Fast ball movement will give the leading forwards the best chance of marking the ball and then hopefully scoring. I say all this because this brand of football is a brand of football that winning clubs adopt, or if they haven't adopted it, they want to adopt it. It's the brand of football the Western Bulldogs are currently playing, I think, and it's what won you the flag in 2016. Would you agree?
In 2016 it did, yes. Yeah, so yeah. Hopefully you can do it again this year.
Exactly. So I bring all that up because you've gone through those lean times, and this is what was happening down at Collingwood. You know, there's people that have left, yourself being in part of that mix. We talk of Jaden Stevenson, Tom Phillips and so forth. But everybody's onto them, and it's like, just ease back a little bit. It's football. They're the things that you need to do, but when you don't have the structure, you don't have the personnel, it's hard, and they're trying to do their best. They've got great players down there. Every club's trying their best to get out there. If you go through all of those rules, or at least that structure, that's what'll get you to the premiership, and that's what happened in 2016. What do you have to say about it?
Yeah, I think, firstly, with kids and players coming into the AFL system in this day and age, you kind of understand that's the reality of the game that we play now, and the media scrutiny that comes with performance, where you're playing in particular. I've obviously played for three clubs now, and I started at the Giants where we were losing my first year by 128 points every week, and we were getting no attention because we were a little known club up there, to then Collingwood where, you know, I've been through the ups and downs of that footy club. My first 2 years there wasn't the most pleasant because we were such a powerful football club and we weren't performing, and it was kind of the expectation that we had to, and you sort of grow a thick skin in a way and kind of get used to the media trying to bring you down. And then, like you said, with the referencing towards Brucey and Naughty, when things do click and you start going well, like it did for us in 2018, we ended up making the grand final, almost winning there. They loved us, absolutely loved us. And then, you know, it happened again last year when we weren't going overly well. And then at the start of this year, even at the Bulldogs, there's all that question mark and, you know, how they're going to make, I guess, a team that has a lot of talented players work. Is it going to work? Now we're 4-0 and it's almost, we're not going to lose the premiership favourites when it's so early. It's all this, I guess, garbage that I like to call, because you start to learn that it's not, the things that aren't important is that kind of thing. And to me, personally for me, and I know Josh is the same, and I know a lot of the players are the same, you seriously just don't pay attention to it. You just don't need to. Like you said earlier there with, you know, player performance, who's at the club, structure, game plan, you actually don't have time to think about what the media has to say, what the commentators, the experts have to say. So for me, it's irrelevant. It's always irrelevant. And if I was at the Collingwood Footy Club now, what they would be saying about us and me, if I was there, would be irrelevant to me because yeah. it doesn't matter about what they think. And inside, internally, I know as a person, as a player, that I'm giving my 100%. I know I'm going to give my all week in, week out. Yeah. We may not be winning. We may be unlucky with injuries. We may have young guys playing. Whatever it is, I'm still giving my absolute all, and that's all that matters to me.
Yeah, good. Great answer, mate. Thank you. I think the timing probably couldn't have been right for me writing this over the weekend and then Collingwood having their loss and then just watching poor old Bucks in his interviews just Monday, Tuesday and today, and I was just going, Jesus, man, I feel for you, as I do for each coach when you go through those hard losses. But it was more relevant to me to just suggest that having you on the show was knowing what that's been like. You've been through GWS, you've been through Collingwood, and now you're at the Doggies. What's it like for you down there without... I don't want to use it as comparison, but what's it been like for you just to get in there for the first four rounds, your pre-season? Everyone's been really accepting of you, and I don't want to go into all the reasons behind it. I just want to speak to you as to how you feel now.
Yeah, it's been great. I've obviously met my best mate. He really is my best friend. Everything you read about us is true, so...
I feel the same way, man.
it was meant to be. But no, it was very daunting for me at the time. I've been quite open about the fact that I actually didn't want to leave, and it was where I wanted to play the rest of my footy. And it's funny that if you ask me that now, it's just like, well, no, I've only ever imagined myself as a Western Bulldogs player because I've been there.
Brilliant.
Yeah, so I'm thoroughly enjoying it. I mean, the hardest thing for me was... You know, I was an established player. I've come into my 10th season, but I still had to kind of find my feet again and meet some new people. And it's very daunting because, you know, I'm naturally a shy person. I do have a lot of anxiety and I worry about what people think. And it was quite scary. But like I said, having guys like Josh and all of them, but especially Josh, to be there and just put their arm around me and have that support. And I felt the love and care from... the minute I walked into the footy club, and I know if you ask Steph Martin the same thing and Mitch Hannon, the guys that came in, they would say the exact same thing. And, the footy that we're playing isn't just because how talented we are and how the game system works. We actually genuinely love and care for each other. And you can see that when we're out there. We play for each other. We feel like we've got a formula that works. And just in terms of the footy side of things, you spoke about the offensive side and the way that we attack the game and whatnot. A lot of our footy is off the back of how well we defend. And that's a massive part of the game in this day and age. So I'm just loving it, mate. I'm really loving it. Like I said, we're playing great footy. It's been an awesome start. There's a few challenging weeks coming against some really good opposition, but we're really looking forward to it.
Bloody awesome. Fantastic, Adam. Stoked for you, mate. When you found out, because now talking about the situation that you probably found yourself in, thinking that trade period and could have gone elsewhere and the circumstance of that, and then you're fortunate enough to be able to still stay at the Western Bulldogs, and then Adam comes along. How did you feel? What was the indelible impression that he gave when he first came to the club for you?
Yeah, so pretty much right from the start, Ads actually messaged me the day after I think the trade period finished, and we hadn't known each other at all. We knew of each other, obviously, obviously had a lot of respect for him playing for Collingwood and GWS, but messaged me the day after the trade and we caught up, I think it was a couple of days after that, and straight away just kicked off. And so Ads' his partner Kim and my sister Lara play together in Queensland, so it's nice to have that connection. And
absolutely.
Ever since day one, it's just been really good, and everything we've done is relates to each other, and we hang out pretty much every day now, don't we, mate?
It's fantastic.
But it's great. Like, and I'm a big believer of everything happens for a reason. So, obviously didn't go the way that I wanted it to, but I'm happy now, and we're all happy that down at the Bulldogs that we're winning games and playing good footy.
Absolutely. Fate's a beautiful thing. I love it. I met my best mate. I moved over here many years ago from Tasmania, and I was working in a bar, and he came in to look for gainful employment, and he came in behind the jump, and I taught him everything behind the bar, and we hit it off as mates, and he was at my wedding. We've just been best mates ever since. So I know what it's like, and that's why I feel for these two. I think it's bloody wonderful. I'm stoked for you. But I want to go back to it. I just want to talk about one of the other points that I alluded to was
knowing your role. Josh, I spoke of defensive pressure as one key attribute. Josh, your smothering skills are like out of this world. I think you, and I saw this stat recently, you had 10 smothers in the first 4 weeks, which was a record. I go on to say, though, your old man was like that at Sydney. Does that mean it's
genetic? Don't tell him that. No.
But that's unbelievable, mate. I mean, oh, it's not so unbelievable. It's just fantastic. Is there anything you attribute that to? Is it just...
Yeah, I've always prided myself on defence. Yeah. You know, from such a young age, I was coached. I played some senior footy when I was 15. Lucky enough back home in Sale to be coached by Matt Ferguson, who had AFL experience as well, and he taught us pretty much to defend first and then everything else will flow from there. So
great.
I've always been, you know, big on my tackling and smothering and stuff like that, so it's just been nice to get a little bit of recognition for the smothers, but yeah, everything else that comes from my game really starts with defence.
Brilliant, mate. Love it, love it, love it. Seriously though, mate, you were looking for a trade. There was the form issue. How have you applied your mind set back into the Doggies culture, the vision and the game plan?
Yeah, I mean, like, the trade stuff, I'm happy to talk about it because it was realistic and it was obviously played out in the media the way that it was. But, you know, I always knew there wasn't a chance it was going to happen, so... I was never disjointed from the footy club, from the players, from the coaches. I had really good conversations with them the whole time. So it was very positive. And to be honest, I'm glad that I went through that and we went through that because I got a lot of things off my chest that I wanted to sort of speak up about, playing-wise, off-field-wise, everything. So it was great to have those conversations. And so for me, pretty much after I met Ads and we walked back into the footy club together, it was really positive and
excellent.
I didn't really think about it too much. And from there, it's been very good since that time. So I'm excited about, and I was excited about what we could do after the trade period, obviously picking up Ads, but Steph Martin is really big for us as well.
Absolutely.
In the ruck, and Mitchie Hannon, who we haven't seen yet, but he's going to add a lot to our group.
Yeah, for sure. Brilliant. If you want to clap, feel free. Ads, I wanted to come back to you. You've come to the club and now you're averaging 25 disposals a game, which is nothing unusual because, you are a ball-getter. I just wanted to find out how... I know I asked you before, but is the culture a lot different for you going down to the kennel? Because it is a... For me, it appears to be a smaller type club, which is more family-oriented. I know Hawthorn want to have that as the family club kind of title, but... What's the culture been like for you?
Clearly it was going to be quite different because, Collingwood and Richmond and Carlton, Essendon, and those are the real big clubs that have the big supporter bases. And I knew that was going to be a lot different for me. I think that was, a massive reason in why I actually wanted to go to the footy club as well. I know when, it wasn't really till 2 days before the trade period, that's how close it was to the trade period that I actually had to decide where I wanted to go, because that's how set on staying at Collingwood I was. And it wasn't until I really thought about it that was a massive part of the reason as well. Reason why I wanted to go to the club was because it wasn't, as big, the fanfare I guess wasn't there. There wasn't, there's always going to be scrutiny and whatnot, but being at Collingwood and having experienced that, it's like nothing else. It really isn't. I can't really explain it. I mean, we have a closed off facility pretty much where media doesn't really come in and see us train. Like every day at the footy club at Collingwood, there's just media there every day. They're in a position where you can't avoid them. You have to talk to them. Yeah. Otherwise you feel like you're rude. And me being who I am, I can't just ignore someone. So I talk to them.
Yeah.
It's just so different in that regard. But in terms of the fan base, you're right. It's a very, very much a family-orientated footy club. It feels like a local footy club in a way, to me. It feels like, I'm playing back at home. I'm only from up the road in Noble Park. Well, in Dandenong, but I play for Noble Park.
Yeah.
I walk in there now and you know everyone. It's a big family club. It's like the same at the Western Bulldogs. I had a couple of nights, first-year players' nights and a couple of other nights where you meet the fans and it's just what it feels like. And my partner Kimmy went to, it might have been the first or second game, and I got a couple of family friends that went, and they've supported me obviously throughout my career, so they've been in all sorts of crowds, and they genuinely, when they said this, they genuinely meant that the Western Bulldogs fan base was the most humble, kind, caring crowd that they've ever been a part of.
Wow.
And they had, and I'm not just saying that.
No.
And I thoroughly believe that because the people that I've met through the footy club, I've seen, I could see that firsthand.
Yeah.
And you do get those, you know, I can't imagine what the Collingwood supporters are like. I mean, out when they're in the crowd and hurling abuse and whatnot. But I'm sure most fan bases are like that. But to get that feedback and me to see that and my partner to actually say that and walk away and be fully impressed with the crowd, like it's something that I've, I guess, wanted for a long time. And now that I have that, I'm hoping I can finish my career at the Bulldogs and they don't want to trade me.
So am I, mate. So am I. I love you as a person. I love you as a player. You bring a lot to the table in every aspect of your life. I think it's fantastic. Whilst I'm on that subject, I didn't see anybody from any of the clubs last year. None of us did. Congratulations on the birth of your child, which is fantastic as well. How's that going for you? What's it like?
It's good. It's good.
Yeah. I've seen some photos on Instagram.
Yeah, it's good. I think she's a little girl, Georgie. I think she's the only girl that's scared of Josh because most girls, most girls are in love with Joshy. But no, she's flying. So look how red he's gone.
Have I got red?
It's the only woman that he doesn't have any effect on. Yeah,
no, she's going good. She's going. So they're up in Queensland. So yeah. She's coming down next week. So,
oh, great.
See her next week. And she's growing. I see her on FaceTime every day. And
oh, that's beautiful.
She loves it. So yeah, she's going well.
Well done, mate. I really am happy for you. The last one I wanted to talk about was reliability and consistency. There was a period where we were going through in 2017, 2018 at Essendon, and everyone was saying no one knew what they stood for. The reliability, the consistency, there just wasn't there. There was no structure. There are many moving parts, so they all need to come together. This is a team bonding thing. You boys, I think you boys have certainly got the team bonding thing. You've got it down to a fine art. You have, because I've had numerous Richmond shows throughout the course of 2017, 2019, nothing in 2020. But I see it in those guys. I ask them a lot, what is it that makes you guys gel on the field? And it's as you pointed out before, Adam, it's just that camaraderie, the love you have for each other. And it's great to see that back in at the Western Bulldogs, because I think that's going to take the Western Bulldogs further in 2021 than you've probably been since 2016. So more power to you, I say. Upcoming games, boys. Ladder position, number one. On top of the ladder. How is that? Four straight. Next three rounds after this one, round six, you come up against GWS. That game is on Friday night, the 23rd at Manuka Oval, 7:50 p.m. I always love those games, man.
It'll be snowing up there, eh?
Yeah, probably. Well, there's every chance it could be. You have an experience going up and playing a Western Bulldogs game against GWS. I'm sure you're very much looking forward to getting into that one.
Yeah, I am. Josh has told me some good stories. the rivalry started before, I think it was the year after I left. That was when the real rivalry came.
He's actually got a part of GWS in him.
I know.
So we've got to get that out of him and make sure that he's fully...
This is why I'm thinking this is going to be interesting. You know, I wonder if you'll be going up to Toby Green and going, "G'day, mate," or rubbing his head into the dirt. Round seven will be a real test. You come up against the Tigers at the G in a Friday night ripper. That's going to be a classic Friday night football. MCG, Tiger Army, you guys could be nearly back to 100% capacity. That will be seriously a game for the ages. Round eight, Sunday afternoon at 3:20 p.m, you're coming up against the Blues at Marvel, who just came off a win against the Suns, whom you guys play this weekend. So this is round five action. Here you boys play the Suns at 4:35 p.m. this Saturday afternoon, April the 17th, which happens to be a fantastic day because it's my birthday. Right on.
Happy birthday.
So go out there and give them a smashing for me. That would be bloody wonderful. Now, we know every game is a big game when you reach the big league. Where do you see this game being won? And I want to ask you this, because you did allude to it before. Across the board, in the ruck, midfield, forward line defence, I'm seriously in love with Tim English's development. Mate, he is coming on leaps and bounds. He's been back and he's got into the weight room. He's got some strength about him. He knows how to position himself. He's learning because of the competitors he's going up against each week. But he's brilliant and so quietly spoken. Let me know a little bit about him. He's like,
Is he as gentle a giant as he appears?
Yeah, he doesn't talk much at the club, to be honest. Like,
I've heard.
But it's been great for Timmy, like obviously getting Steph Martin in. Jordan Sweet's another one that's been developing as well. So to get Steph in, it's obviously allowed him to play a little bit more time forward and help out Brucey and Naughty. So it's been really positive for him. But like you mentioned, he's been in the gym working really hard in the off-season and put on some size, and yeah, it's going to be exciting to see how he goes this year because he's obviously playing some great footy for us.
It's great. He's so versatile. You throw him into the ruck, you throw him down back, you can put him up forward. He's just brilliant. Speaking of which, Stephen Martin, what a great acquisition to your ruck stocks there as well. He's brought a lot to the table. I talk about a couple of injuries. Caleb accepted his one little weak ban for that tissue that he threw, which was ruled as a dangerous tackle ruling. You have injuries to Ed Richards, Ryan Gardner and Toby McLean, obviously. Long term there for Toby still. But we may see the possible return of both the Mitches. Could we see maybe Wallace, Mitch Hannon?
Mitchy Hannon's actually concussed, so he might... missed last week. Yeah. So I think he's due back this week to play in the VFL, but VFL. I'm not sure... We train tomorrow as a main squad, so we'll wait and see what the coaches have to say, all the cliche.
Yeah, there you go with that one. Longer-term injury, obviously, also to Hayden Crozier. But I think what everyone in the room would like to know, how far off is Jamar Ugel-Hagan?
I don't know, honestly. He's physically fine, so he's playing.
Yeah.
But it's one of those things, you don't just throw him in there because he's number one draft pick and whatnot. And what we've got going up forward, he's working really well for us. So I can't give you the answer, but I've got no doubt you'll see him at some stage this year. But what he's doing at VFL level is awesome. His strengths are really shining. And I think his ability to read the play and take marks at a tightest point and create a contest. And he's real agile on his feet as well. And he can get up the ground and I guess use his long left leg because he's got a really nice kick on him as well. So... I'm not sure when he's going to come in, but
he's obviously impressed you around the ground. Watching him training and everything.
You can see why he was regarded so highly. What he can provide aerially around the ground for a big guy, and I think when the ball hits the ground, you haven't seen many as agile as he is. He's obviously still got to find the balance between, you know, being a professional football player, but still, I guess, enjoying himself at the same time. He's still a little bit struggling with that at the moment, but. He'll be right. He'll be a gun. He really will. He'll be a star for us. And it does take time. I mean, you look at, I'm not comparing him to Buddy Franklin, but it makes me think of when I first watched him in his first year when I was a kid. He was so raw and you just thought he could be anything.
Yeah.
Jamara has that about him as well. He's just got to make sure he's got the right head on his shoulders and he wants to get the job done.
Good on him. Great. Very exciting times, Bulldogs fan. Very exciting times. Whilst you're at it, just keep that applause going. That's the end of that segment. That was called What's Going On. Thanks, boys. What's going on? Yeah, what's going on? All right, I'm going to introduce the segment. It's called Simply the Best. You're simply the best. Better than all. Quite appropriate. It could be a real Bulldog song this year anyway. So we've got Darcy down the front and we've got Isaac. Nice to have you here. To explain this segment, as I said, it's called Simply the Best. You two boys claim, as you did, in front of this whole audience as witnesses, that you know a lot about the Western Bulldogs Football Club. So what's going to happen is I'm going to be asking you 20 questions about the Western Bulldogs Football Club in its history. Okay? The first one to buzz in with the correct answer will be awarded the point. You have to use your buzzer, though. Your buzzer is your name. Could you test your buzzer, please, Darcy?
Darcy.
Excellent. Could you test yours, Isaac?
Isaac.
Excellent. Your buzzers are working. This is exciting. All right. So what's going to happen here? The boys are going to keep score for you. Darcy, Adam Treloar is going to keep score for you. We've got a really elaborate scoring system up here. It's a table tennis paddle with a couple of restaurant numbers. The same is going to be happening for you, Isaac. Josh Dunkley is going to be keeping score for you. So whenever you hear this noise... That means that you got the question right. If you hear this noise, you got the question wrong. So you got 20 questions, and we're going to reel them off now. Buzz in with your buzzer. Don't be like the guy we had last week that just started screaming out the answers and never used his buzzer. That was just annoying. So don't be annoying. Be wonderful. All right, here comes your first question, boys. Which Western Bulldogs Footscray player has played the most games in the history of the club? Wait until I finish the whole question. Is it A, Doug Hawkins, B, Chris Grant, or C, Brad Johnson?
Isaac.
Isaac.
Brad Johnson.
Correct. Not for a bonus point, but do you know how many games it might have been?
364.
Oh, my God. The guy's a champion. Well done, Isaac. Wow. Good stuff, mate. Darcy, you can have your work cut out for you, I reckon. I'll keep that microphone nice and close. All right. How many VFL, AFL grand finals has the Western Bulldogs Football Club played in?
Darcy.
Darcy.
Two. Oh, wait. Played in.
Played in.
Oh. Isaac. Three. No.
I could have still taken your answer, Darcy, but Isaac's jumped in and he was right with three. I told you, he's going to be quick. Here we go, boys. Who is your team's captain?
Isaac.
Isaac.
Marcus Bontempelli.
Correct. Out of these three players, who has captained the Western Bulldogs Football Club the most? A, Brad Johnson, B, Chris Grant, or C, Scott Wine?
Darcy.
Chris Grant. Darcy.
Chris Grant.
Chris Grant.
You came in first and you got it wrong. Sorry, mate. Do you want to have a go, Isaac?
Brad Johnson.
No, it was Scott Wine. Bad luck. Western Bulldogs have finished on top of the ladder at the end of the home and away season in its history, a total of A, three times, B, once, or C, never?
Isaac.
Isaac.
Never.
That's correct, mate. Well done. Where did the Western Bulldogs finish on the ladder at the end of the home and away season last year?
Isaac.
Isaac.
Seventh.
Correct. He's a ringing, this kid. He's bloody good. Well done. Yeah. Laying it down. All right. Who wears the number seven at the Western Bulldogs?
Isaac.
Isaac.
Lockie Hunter.
Correct. For 2 points, this is for player and goals. Who was your club's leading goal kicker in 2020 and how many goals did they kick?
Isaac.
Isaac.
Aaron Norton. No, it was Mitch Wallace.
Oh, nice. Correct. Yes, it was Mitch Wallace.
32?
No. Do you have a go, Darcy? It is Mitch Wallace. You've got 1 point there.
23.
25. Bad luck. Not bad. At least you got to have. At least you got to use your microphone. That's great. Well done. How many games did your team win last year at the end of the home and away season?
Isaac.
Isaac?
10.
Correct, mate. Well done. We might have to get him up here as a panellist, I reckon. He's bloody good. Hey, name three coaches over the last 20 years.
Isaac.
Isaac.
Luke Beveridge, Brendan McCartney and Ronnie Eade.
You're a champion. Well done. All right. How many losing grand finals has the Western Bulldogs played in?
Isaac.
Darcy. Oh.
Give it to Darcy. Give it to Darcy. He needs one.
One.
You're all saying Darcy?
Yeah, give it to Darcy.
Hands up for Darcy. Even if he didn't, Darcy, what do you got, mate? How many?
One.
Well done. 1961. It's really good you did that, because Adam was about to leave. He's like, Adam's very competitive. He likes to get involved. Closest to within 1,000. How many members does your club currently have?
Isaac.
Isaac.
41.
41. Did you want to have a go, Darcy?
40.
Oh, no.
You got it, because it's closer to within 1,000. It's 38,876. So well done.
Is that quadruple points?
Quadruple points, no. No, just one. Nice try, though. I told you he's competitive. He's the kind of guy you want playing for your team. Don't worry about that. Out of these three Western Bulldogs grand finals, which had the largest crowd in attendance? Was A, 2016 versus Sydney, B, versus Hawthorne, or was it C, 1954 versus Melbourne?
Isaac.
Isaac?
I believe it was Bulldogs versus Sydney.
No.
Darcy.
No. Bulldogs. No. So your other options are B, 1961 versus Hawthorne, or C, 1954 versus Melbourne?
Hawthorne, 1961.
Oh, you got it. Well done. All right. 107,935 people. Wow, what a game that would have been. How many premierships has the Western Bulldogs Football Club won?
Darcy.
Darcy.
Two.
All right. Well done, mate. Isaac, this doesn't mean we're not rooting for you too, brother. It's all good. Who out of these three players has won the most BNFs at the Western Bulldogs Football Club? Is it A, Gary Dempsey, C, Brad Johnson, or C, Scotty West?
Isaac. Darcy.
Oh, Isaac.
Scott West.
It is, mate. Well done. Get that microphone underneath your chin here, Darcy, because this is worth 3 points, as it is to you as well, Isaac. For 3 points, player, year and votes. How many votes, what year, and who was the last Bulldogs player to win a Brownlow medal?
Isaac.
Isaac.
Adam Cooney, 2008, 23 votes.
You've got 2 points. Do you want to have a guess at how many votes? He's got everything else right.
28.
No, 24. Bad luck, Isaac. So close, mate. But you get 2 points for that one. How many Brownlow medalists has the Western Bulldogs Club Football Club produced in its history? Is it A6, B10 or C8?
Darcy. Isaac.
Oh, Darcy.
Six.
No.
Eight.
No. It's B10. All right. What year did your team last win a grand final and who did they play?
Isaac.
Isaac?
2016, we played Sydney and we won by 22 points.
Wow, that was question number 19, so I'm going to have to read that then. How many points did you win that by? 22 points. He got 2 points. And this is the last question. We'll make it worth 9 points.
This is a bit unfair.
It's okay. It's 14 versus 4, so you're way out in front. Last question. What year and who was the last Western Bulldogs player to win the Norm Smith medal?
Isaac.
Isaac?
2016, Jason Johannesson.
You are a champion. You are simply the best. You're simply the best. Wow. Seriously. Oh, no. Come back. That was seriously fantastic. What I've got for you, don't be disgruntled, don't be disconcerted. If I can balance that one there. That's yours for a runner-up. Okay. Don't be disappointed, it's all yours. You can get it signed by the boys. If you could go down there to that, see that buffalo bag? That's yours. $299 noise-cancelling headphones from Yamaha. Well done. Good stuff, all right? Well done. Brilliant. Let's introduce it. It's called You Took the Words Right Out of My Mouth. Why you took the words right out of my mouth? Why you took the words right out of my mouth? All right, let's hope we never hear from that guy again. We never want to see him in an AFL grand final, I'll tell you. This segment is proudly brought to you by the big picture people in Yamaha. What this segment is all about is because of their businesses, the big picture people in Yamaha, what they actually do is they look after home theatres, surround sound, biggest in the business. If you're ever looking for anything for your home, for home cinema, get onto the big picture people, and Yamaha are a great sponsor as well. But because of what they do with home movies and so forth, I've got a segment called You Took the Words Right Out of My Mouth. I'm going to be giving you two lovely gentlemen a movie line, okay? It's a famous movie line from a movie. I want you to tell me what movie it's from, and then I just want you to tell me the actor that actually said that line, all right? So I'm going to rule those off. We've got Mel and Sian down the front here. They're going to be playing on behalf of you. So, Sian, you're going to be playing for Adam Treloar. And Mel, you'll be playing for Josh Dunkley. All right. So here we go. Are you ready, boys? Are you excited? Are you ready to jump out of
this? I'm going to be shocking at this.
Let's see how we go. I'm not going to try and voice it the way that it's, you know, done in the movie because that would just be ridiculous. So let's just go with, you can't handle the truth.
Are we meant to, like, buzz in?
Oh, yeah. That'd be...
Buzz.
Buzz. You can say Adam or Buzz or...
I can't handle the truth.
You can't handle the truth.
I've heard it, but yeah. I don't know.
Famous movie, famous actor.
Do you know Joss?
No idea.
Good. No? Not ringing any bells?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah.
You can't handle it. What is that?
would you like one of your...
Yeah. Who knows it?
Jack Nicholson.
Well, they both.
Yeah,
know.
Who's saying what? Anyone?
Jack Nicholson.
Mel, yes. Jack Nicholson, movie?
Few Good Men.
That'll do. All right, you got it. Beautiful. There you go, see? That's not a knife. This is a knife.
Buzz.
Yes.
That's the Australian bloke. Is it Crocodile Dundee?
Yes, it is. Yeah, beautiful. And the actor?
Paul, is it? Yeah. Paul Hogan?
Yeah! Beautiful. Well done. All right. Show me the money.
Buzz, is that he's the Tom Cruise?
Yes.
He manages someone.
Player manager?
He player manages someone, but I don't know what the movie's called. Jerry Maguire.
Thank you, everyone.
Sure, that's a point.
No, well done. Yes, there is a point there. Well done. We'll get you involved, mate.
I'm going to be terrible at this. I don't watch movies.
We'll try this one. To infinity and beyond.
Buzz. Buzz Lightyear. Toy Story.
I knew that one.
I'm not going to lose.
They may take our lives, but they will never take our
Buzz,
freedom.
That is Mel Gibson, Braveheart.
All right. Yeah, well done. He's getting in good because he knows that other segment's coming up soon, which he's not.
I'll just wait. I'll take it. I'll take it.
No, I love it. Play your cards right. Here you go. Wilson!
Buzz, Tom Hanks, Castaway.
Yes, beautiful. Well done. I see dead people.
Buzz. Seventh Sense? Sixth Sense?
Come down a number.
Is it a kid? Yeah. The kid's name. What's the kid's name?
Dakota Fanning.
No.
No.
Who?
Very good. Correct. Who? You got it. Haley Joel Osment. Beautiful. Well done.
Wouldn't have a clue.
No. I'm king of the world.
And then just ask everyone.
Go, buzz in, mate. You go.
I'm king of the world.
Buzz.
Yes. Who was it, Josh?
Titanic.
Titanic. Do you know who the person was that said it? The actor?
Leo.
No.
Leo.
Leonardo DiCaprio.
Right. Okay, it was Leo. Yeah, screaming out Leo.
Right, we'll get one.
Okay, we'll try a couple more and see how we go. Life is like a box of chocolates.
Buzz, Tom Hanks.
Yes.
Forrest Gump.
Yes, well done. All right, just two more. We'll go with two more.
Is that because you know I've already won?
What's that?
Love that. Love that.
Something like that. Yeah, and I've got to keep these people entertained. The first rule of Fight Club is you don't talk about Fight Club.
You go, mate. It's in the movie. It's in the sentence.
Fight Club.
Yeah, good.
I don't know who says it.
No good.
Is it Brad Pitt?
Brad Pitt, it is. Give him a point each. Why not? Okay. How are we going down there score-wise then, Mel? What? Three and...
Oh, smashing it.
Oh, yeah. I love the confidence. All right. One last one. Roads. Where we're going, we don't need roads.
Mm. Oh. Who, me? Buzz?
Back to the Future.
Oh. Back to the Future?
And? Who said it?
The Taylor, right?
Yes. Yeah, well done. All right. That's it. We have a winner. All right. What did we finish? What did you finish up with as a score? A total of 9. Well done, madam. You've done it. Josh, you will be able to seek your revenge as time goes on. That'll be beautiful. Mel, you're a winner. Congratulations. No, I was just testing you. Just testing. You're our winner.
Yeah.
See that bag down there? That one? No, Mel. You still get something, darling. That's yours. All right. Congratulations. See that bag? Everything that's in it, it's yours. Take the bag, everything. Whole lot. Yeah, thank you. Now let's introduce the segment, Sam. It's called Say My Name. This is a classic because poor little Josh was sitting there before and he wasn't really participating. He's got the chance to come back now. Adam's probably going to be the one sitting there not doing a hell of a lot during this segment. It is called Say My Name. The way that this segment works, Matt, you're going to be keeping score for Adam Treloar. Interesting. Nathan, you're going to be keeping score for Josh. Okay? That's how it's going to work. What I'm going to be doing here is I'm going to be reading out the players' numbers from the current list of the Western Bulldogs Football Club.
See, Josh is expected to win this, so if I win...
Yeah, I know. That's what I was thinking when I put it together. The thing is, they've got 45 seconds on the clock, and they've got to give me their Christian name and the surname of each player when I call it out. Who would like to go first?
Adam.
Yeah. All right.
I'm the leader of us two, so I'll always go.
So... here we go. It's 45 seconds on the clock. It'll start with my first one. Matt, if you hear this noise, that means that he got it right. Turn over the paddle. If he gets it wrong, you'll hear this noise. If you don't know, feel free just to say pass.
Don't worry, mate. I will.
Good. Are you ready to go, Adam?
Yes.
All right. Let's start with your first one. Your time starts now. Number 35.
Pass.
Caleb Daniel. Number 20.
Ed Richards.
Correct. Number 27.
Pass.
Patrick Lipinski, number 31.
Pass.
Bailey Dale, number 39.
Far out.
Pass. Jason Johannesson, number 44.
Tim English.
Excellent. Number 37.
Rourke Smith.
Beautiful. Excellent. Number 17.
Josh Bruce.
Beautiful. Number 6.
Bailey Smith.
Correct. Number 2.
Lewis Young.
Correct. Number 11.
Jackson McRae.
Excellent. Number 8.
Stephen Martin.
Beautiful. Number 16.
Toby McLean.
Beautiful. 42.
Gardy? Ryan Gardner?
No. Alex Keith. Number 23. I'll give you number 23. I'll give you number 23 if you can get
Hold
it.
Hold on. Sorry, what?
Number 23. It was right on the buzzer.
Bus, he said.
Vandermeer. Latham Vandermeer.
There you go. All right. Finish up with a total score of 10. Not bad. Credit where credit's due. That was wonderful. Good stuff, mate. I like that. Are you ready to go, Josh?
I'm ready. I'm
this
ready.
Is going to be... all right. Nathan, you all set? All right. Here we go, mate. I'm going to start with your first one, and your time will start now. Number 4.
Mark Spondapelli.
Correct. Number 5.
Josh Dunkley.
Correct. Number 14.
Riley West.
Correct. Number 12.
Zane Cordy.
Correct. Number 30.
Lockie McNeil.
Correct. Number 46.
Lin Jong.
Correct. Number 1.
Adam Treloar.
Excellent. Number 3.
Mitch Wallace.
Correct. Number 15.
Taylor Dre.
Correct. Number 22.
Jamara Ewbehagelin.
Excellent. Number
32. Dom?
Will Hayes. Oh. Number 9.
Hayden Crozier.
Correct. Number 10.
Easton Wood.
Correct. Number 13.
Josh Shackey.
Correct. Number 19.
Cody Waitman.
Correct. Number 21.
Thomas Liberatore.
Yes, yes. Number 38.
Riley Garcia.
Correct. Number 26.
Dom.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Benendo.
Yes. Beautiful. All right. How'd you go? 17. All right. I'm impressed with both of them. That was seriously... What do you boys do? Do you go around the locker room? Is it?
I clearly don't, because I didn't remember the first. Although my first numbers are all... above 30. His first were 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
That's why I went second, mate.
See, there's method to the madness. That was seriously cool, though. Well done to both of you. Boys, you're both winners, all right? You both get a footy. That's it. Simple as that. Leave those score pads down there. That's it for our segment. That's yours, Matt. That's yours, Nathan. Thanks very much. Good of you to get involved. Well done.
Thanks,
excellent. Handshakes all around. All right. Here we go. All right. What we're going to do now, this is our last little segment before we'll get you to all line up and get your photos done with the boys. As I said, keep your social distancing, all that sort of stuff. I've been watching handshaking and everything and whatever going on, but just to be on the safe side. But we'll get your photos done after this segment. I'm going to introduce it. It's a segment called What Can I Say? All right, this is good, boys. There's nobody to get involved but you two, and it's just however you feel, all right? The answers are exactly what comes, first thing that comes to mind. So I'm just going to reel them off, and you just spurt it on out. Which one of these things gets you pumped the most before a game of football? Is it the smell of deep heat, fresh-cut grass, pulling on the jumper, strapping on the boots, a footy in your hands, or the sound of the crowd?
For me, sound of the crowd.
Mine would probably be...
Deep heat.
Yeah.
He's the only one that wears deep heat.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Wow.
No, you're probably the deep heat.
Yeah. Good. I like it. Excellent. Who is the most manicured down at the club?
No. No way. I just pride myself on how I smell.
Oh, yeah.
Because there's a lot of boys at the club that stink.
Most manicured, from what I've seen.
Scotty. Anthony Scott.
Yeah, Scotty as well. Woody is as well.
Yeah, Woody, yeah.
Scotty, Woody.
Yeah.
Yeah, probably those two.
Okay, all right, good. Do you miss running through the banners at the moment?
100%.
Yep.
Yeah,
100%.
Good. Bring them back.
Yeah. When is it? Do they know when they're coming back? Or?
Round 7.
Round 7.
Oh, cool. Sweet. Round 6. After round 6?
Round 7.
So for round 7?
Is that
only possible? No.
That's the Richmond game, is it?
Yep. Yeah. So could that be the MCG Richmond game?
Beautiful.
Fingers crossed. There. There you go. Good luck. All right. The siren is gone. You need a goal to win the game. Who do you hope has got the ball in the hands to win the game for you?
Adam.
Definitely not me. Who would I want? Yeah, he was a good kick. No, no, good I reckon kick. There's... You know...
I reckon Aaron Norton's got a...
Yeah,
really
I would say Naughty. I was about to say Naughty.
Okay, Naughty. Let's go with that. What are your thoughts on Thursday night football?
Well, we don't play the Doggies, do we?
We haven't for a long time. The last time we played, I reckon, was the final, elimination final.
I don't mind it as long as the next week we play on the Sunday. So... We can, you know, enjoy the weekend instead of having to prepare for the next game.
Okay. The Western Bulldogs supporters are?
Well, what I touched on before, I reckon, about how they're kind, caring, great crowd to be involved with.
Beautiful.
Yeah, pretty much what I said.
You guys, it's all you.
Very passionate.
Very passionate. All right. Which AFL club do you like to beat the most?
GWS.
Well, mine clearly was Collingwood, but GWS as well.
Excellent. All right. Do you prefer a day or a twilight grand final?
Day, for sure.
Day. Good.
Tradition.
Yes.
Be tradition.
I'm with you, mate. Absolutely. If you were to describe yourself as a car, what sort of a car would you be?
Are you laughing about me?
Yeah.
What am I?
I don't know, a Mercedes.
Oh, thanks, mate. Appreciate that. Excellent. Yeah, he drives a Mercedes. That's why.
Nice plug too. I like it.
I don't know what you are, mate.
Maserati?
What's a good-looking car? What's something that's really good-looking?
Just an old Dodge or something.
Ah, yeah. All right. Classic. Who's the funniest bloke down at the club?
Cal Porter.
Oh, yeah.
He used to be a very good joke teller. Yeah. Bevo thinks he's the funniest, but he's not. We've actually got a dad jokes book?
Oh, yeah.
So before every meeting, a player gets up and reads out a joke from the book, and they are shocking. But Bevo loves it. He's the only one laughing in the corner.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, I'll disagree with the dunks.
Yeah, okay. Being an AFL footballer to you is?
I'm grateful. Yeah. Just very grateful because we're very lucky to be in the position that we're in. But we've worked hard for it, obviously. Yeah. But yeah, grateful.
Yeah. Mm, I'm the same. Yeah, very grateful.
Good. Good. I like it. Who is tight with their money down at the club?
Well, I only hang out with Josh, so I don't know.
Mitch Wallace has got the nickname Wallet.
Oh, really?
Because he used to be very tight with his money.
I like it.
I don't
okay.
know who would be now, though.
Yeah, good. I know the roof is going to be closed now because the AFL have ruled it, but do you prefer Eddie had roof open or closed?
Closed.
Well, true.
All the time. I hear you. In your opinion, who down at the club has got the most swagger?
Jado.
Our property steward, Jado.
Yeah, really?
Or Bailey Smith.
Yeah.
Bailey Smith.
Yeah. He has got swagger. You're applying for a position as a footballer, similar to a job interview. What do you write down about yourself?
What do I write down?
Hardworking, committed.
Oh, I like it.
I'm the same. I'm focused, competitive. I'd have to write competitive.
Yeah. Yeah, good. I like it. What is your favourite ground to play on around Australia, apart from the G?
I love Adelaide Oval.
Yeah.
Okay. Yep. Atmosphere.
But I also love Marvel. I love Marvel. And never really got the chance to play there at Collingwood, so yep. I love playing there.
Okay.
Obda Stadium's pretty cool as well.
Yeah, right.
Perth,
okay,
new
good.
Perth one.
Yep. Playing for the Western Bulldogs is?
Yeah, it's great.
Yeah.
Cheesy,
but it's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's cheesy, but it's awesome. I like
it. Just great to represent the fans and you know, all the love that they give us. And
how good's that? I look around at the room and I'm looking at all of your faces individually, and I would love to have these two players representing my club, and you guys have, I'm pretty passionate too. I might have to switch clubs. Who was your Brownlow tip for 2021?
I think Jacko McRae would be ahead of him at the moment.
I think Nader would be winning our one, Jackson McRae.
For the league.
It'll be hard for a Bulldogs player because there's so many good players. For the league, I don't know, probably... Oh, I really don't know.
Yeah.
Probably Dusty. Dusty's flying at the moment. Dusty.
All right. What's better, mark or goal of the year?
Well, goal, because I don't take marks. So.
Goal. Yeah. Yeah, goal.
Yeah, yeah. Settle for that. The Western Bulldogs at the end of the home and away season this year will finish?
Top four, hopefully.
Top four, hopefully, yeah.
Yeah.
Top four, hopefully, as well.
Top four, mate.
Okay. Who grinds your gears as a football commentator?
Oh, there's plenty, mate. No, there's plenty. I don't need to name them, but there's plenty.
Yeah, plenty. All right. Go with the same answer?
Yeah.
All right. Should Tasmania have a team of their own?
Yes. I reckon they should.
I think so, yeah.
Good, I do too. Do you prefer to see the coach on the bench or in the box?
Depends what mood he's in. And if we're winning.
There's always that.
Bevo's better in the box.
Yeah, right.
Well, I haven't experienced him on the bench, so I'll
say safer answer. All right. Who does their hair the most at the club?
Does their hair?
Nah, Baz doesn't really Baz touch doesn't it. All really... he does is just like...
Yeah.
Plays it.
He's always doing
it's
that
It's all very natural. Like, who actually does their hair? Like, puts wax and whatnot in it? Peter Lipinski puts wax in it.
He does, yep.
Now, Naughty is kind of natural in a way.
Timmy puts a bit of work in. He does, yeah.
Yeah.
Nah, Woody, for sure.
Yeah, Woody's very well-groomed.
Oh, he's chiselled that boy, isn't he? Yeah, I'll show you a print of you shortly. You have to give a character reference about each other. What would you say?
How long's the sentence? What do I get?
Just surmise it.
Well, are we being real, like, sentimental, or are we taking the piss out of each other?
Either. Actually, it's a good point. I never thought about it. I'm happy with your answer. Whatever you want to choose.
Oh, well, what you see is what you get with Josh. Like, he's...
Yeah.
I don't know what to say because I love him.
Yeah.
Yeah, what you see is what you get. He's a kind, caring, hardworking person who will always have your back.
Beautiful.
Make you feel welcome. Beautiful. Love you no matter what. Yeah, he's a good man. He's a good man.
Love it. Would you like to reciprocate?
Yeah, well, Adam's exactly the same, isn't he? That's why we get along.
Beautiful.
I think it's great to be mates.
Yeah, good. Yeah. Love and marriage. Love. How many of you have got a lump in your throat at the moment? Yeah, love and marriage. Beautiful. All right. Who is the most famous person in your phone and have you ever rung them?
He did a good one on the channel.
Yeah, Andrew Dunkley. He's dad.
Yeah, right.
Most famous... Oh, probably Eddie Maguire. It'd be Eddie Maguire.
Okay, yep.
And I have rang him, yes.
No.
Mine would be Antonio Brown, NFL.
Oh, wow.
He's well, like, he would have how many followers on Instagram? 10 million?
Yeah, probably more.
Yeah.
Wow.
He's an NFL wide receiver.
Brilliant.
Super Bowl okay. winner.
Yeah, right.
We were lucky enough to train with him a couple of years ago.
Josh cooked him breakfast at his house in Florida.
Yeah.
That's right. I've heard that story. Sorry. Yeah, now it's all... Yeah. Wow. What an experience that must have been.
Yeah, that was incredible. It was incredible. It happened really quickly, but it was...
Yeah. Weird. And what did you make? What was breakfast?
Well, it was funny. We walked into his house. I'll tell the story. Might as well tell the story. Yeah. Walked into his house and his chef was sick. And the first thing he pretty much said to us was, you know, hello and how you going, rah, rah. And then he's like, oh, my chef's sick. Do you want to cook breakfast? And I was like, yeah, sure thing. So looked in his fridge. He added all this organic meat, like just layers of meat. And it was incredible. So he made eggs and then mince meat because it was sort of brunch time around 11 o'clock.
Yeah.
So he made eggs and meat and toast and a bit of spinach and that was it.
And what did he say?
Thank you.
Wow. What an experience that must have been.
Yeah, it was pretty cool. Hayden Crozier and I were there and another mate, Cam Marshall. So
yeah, right. Wow.
Yeah, also Antonio Brown signs his NFL balls every touchdown. Every touchdown he catches, he signs one of the balls and he keeps them.
Yep.
He pinched one of them from his bedroom.
I didn't pinch it. He had about 40 of them.
Yeah.
Because we went and trained with him after breakfast
And
then came back to the house, did some recovery and then... We were sort of just doing our own thing and we decided to go. And then before we left, I just asked him for one of his balls and sure enough, it's in my cupboard at home.
That is gold, mate. That is seriously good. What an experience. He must have seen something in you and just thought, like you have and like I do, he just, wow, that's brilliant. What a story. What an experience. Thanks, mate. Makes all these other questions seem ridiculous now, but that's seriously, that's bloody awesome. If there was one form of entertainment, listening or viewing, which would you choose? One form of entertainment, listening or viewing?
Oh, okay. That's a tough one. That's real. So it's either music or movies, pretty much.
Yeah.
Nah, I'll watch. You heard me in the movie quotes, mate. I watch the movies.
Yeah, I'm more of a listener, obviously.
Yeah. Cool. All right. Okay, I like it. What do you think when you see a poster or merchandise of yourself?
What are you laughing at me?
I know what you say. You're always like, yuck. Looks at himself.
I don't like the way that I look. Nah, it's pretty cool. Yeah, yeah. It's awesome.
Yeah,
good. I like it now that I'm wearing the red, white and blue. But
exactly. Good stuff. Your answer?
I don't know.
Yeah. He's different. He goes, oh, have a look at that bloke.
Yeah, baby. Yeah.
Oh. I like it. Here's your last one, boys. What is your reaction when you see a kid with your number on their back? And I speak about not just necessarily you at the Western Bulldogs now, but just your football journey.
Yeah, I think that's a bit different. Like, you're very proud to obviously be that kid's favourite player.
Yeah.
So, yeah, if I saw it, I'd instantly go up to him and say good day or brilliant. He or she.
That's yeah, nice. No, they're definitely the ones that you go out of your way for to make their day feel a lot more special because I remember when I was a kid, I used to... Back for Carlton, so I had the number 43 on my back, Anthony Koutafidis.
Very special experience. I love what you guys have brought to the table tonight. As I said before, it's not just here at this show, it's who they are as people. I get a vibe from both of them. I have from all the years I've done the shows with you. As soon as I met you, I felt the same way. It's fantastic to have them both here, and you should be very proud of them. Can you put your hands together for both of them? That was our... That was our segment, What Can I Say? What I want to do now is I just want to say thank you to all of you, you know. There was some people in the room tonight that have never been before. Have you had a good time?
Yeah.
Thank you. Thanks to all of you. I just wanted to let you know... each week we do two current day players from each of the 10 Victorian clubs. Coming up on April the 21st, we've got Carlton players Harry Mackay and Jack Silvani. On April the 28th, we've got Collingwood players Josh Dacos and Jeremy Howe. All still to come. We also have live shows featuring players from Hawthorn and Geelong. So that'll move us into May. And then we'll start moving back again and we'll start doing all the clubs again so we can do another Western Bulldog show. Which means if you had a good time tonight, tell your friends and bring them along next time because the more people that can come along, the better it is. As we're slowly finding our way back to the new COVID post-normal, please understand at this stage, tickets are only available through the That's Good For Footy website. Simply go to www.thatsgoodforfooty.com.au/events. Click on the links in the That's Good For Footy post on the That's Good For Footy Facebook page. It's all pretty simple, isn't it? These shows are recorded live at the Mulgrave Country Club, which is in Wheelers Hill, opposite the old VFL Park. If you'd like to be kept informed, as I said before, get onto the Facebook page and sign up. The information can then come to you. Go and like the page, get all the information. Now, can I please get you to put your hands together for Sam and Sandy? Thank you very much. A lot of people probably say it sarcastically, but they think there's quite a few people that put these shows together. There isn't. It's just three of us. But we love doing it, and we love your support, and we love the players coming along and being part of it. So thanks to all of you once again. Whilst you're thanking everybody, put your hands together for Adam Treloar and Josh Dunkley. Two finer representatives from the Western Football Club I don't think you'll find, although I've had quite a few players on and you guys, just freaking brilliant. First time being a Western Bulldogs player back on, second time back on for you. How'd you guys go? Did you enjoy tonight?
Oh, yeah, I enjoyed tonight more than last time because we've got ads in here, mate.
I'll leave it there.
Yeah, on that note, yeah, let's all sign off. That was beautiful. I just love it. We hope you've all had a good time tonight. Thanks a lot for your support. This has been the That's Good For Footy panel show. My name's Damien. Thank you and good night. Cheers, everyone.